way past their bedtime, but I'll tell you what. We'll call and make arrangements to have everybody from the orphanage over here tomorrow for a big Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Sure, why not? Miss Hannigan, too. Annie? I'm the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid.
Together at last, together forever. We're tying a knot they never can sever. I don't need sunshine now to turn my skies to blue. I don't need anything but you. Wrap me around that cute little finger. You made life a song. You made me a singer.
And put that faster tune, you're with
Bobo. Bobo, anything but you.
Yesterday was my uncle.
You can say that again.
Yesterday was my uncle.
That's
now.
That's it.
I'm older than
now. I'm richer than Midas. Nothing on earth can ever divide us. And if tomorrow I'm an apple filler too, I don't need anything but you.
Excuse me, sir. Everyone is spiffed up for the party.
Fine, Drake. Grace?
Yes.
Why don't you take Annie? I think we should get spiffed up too. Have Annette put her into one of her new white wigs. That's a very pretty dress you have.
Thank you, sir.
Have Annette put her into one of her new dresses. Have Cecile do something with her hair and I don't know. Gussie her up.
Yes, sir. Gussie her up.
Gussie her up, Annie, 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 everything's humming now.
Annie, 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 good times are coming now, since you came away. It's Christmas, Christmas every day. We dismiss bedtime.
For us, Annie, 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 turned on the fun for us.
Haven't it the cheek?
Yes, and iced ham and brie.
Judge Brandeis,
Annie, Annie, you will all our grill of
soul. Welcome, my friends, to the happiest night of my life.
Ralph Mudge, and this here's the wife, Shirley.
You never knew it, dear, but your
you're Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge?
We were sick and broke, and we didn't know which way to turn, and a man up in Canada offered us a chance to work on his farm.
But we couldn't bring along no baby.
We loved you, Annie, but we had to leave you behind.
Mr. Mudge, is it? We've seen a great number of people about this today.
Please, I expect you'll be wanting proof of who we are. Here's our driver's licenses and Annie's birth certificate.
Baby girl. Name Ann Elizabeth Mudge, born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge, New York, New York, October
28, 1922. October 28th, that's my birthday.
It was in her notes, sir.
Yes, I know. But I,
Mr. Please, you got to believe us. We got off to Greyhound this afternoon and we went straight to the orphanage to fetch our Annie, and the lady there told us our baby was up here.
Oh, Annie. All the years I've dreamed of holding you in my arms again.
Mr. Mudge, on the night that Annie was left...
Here's something you wouldn't know, but on the night we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half a silver locket with her, and we kept the other half so we could...
Ralph, look! Annie's wearing it!
And here's the part we kept, and... Yes, it's perfect!
Oh, thank God, Ralph! She is our Annie!
She seems to be.
Oh, she is. She is. Now, if you'll be getting Annie's things together, we'll be taking her along with us.
Take her.
No!
Wait a minute. What about the money?
Money? Well, we ain't got much, but we'd be glad to give you whatever we got.
You haven't heard about the certified check for $50,000 that I've offered to anyone who can prove they're Annie's parents?
No, sir. We don't know nothing about no check. Anyway, we don't want no money.
Right. We don't want no money for Annie.
On the other hand, Shirley, you remember that little pig farm out in New Jersey? The $50,000 we could afford to bring Annie up right out in the country where they got lots of fresh air and fresh eggs and...
Fresh ham?
Fresh ham. Certified. So all I got to do is make it out to myself.
That's correct. Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning?
You don't mind if Annie spends one more night, Christmas Eve. You can come back tomorrow morning, pick up Annie and her things, and the check.
Oh, well, yes, sir, but whatever you prefer. Well, I think it's time we got back to our hotel now. Bye, Annie.
Bye, Annie, love.
Until tomorrow morning, when you'll be spending the rest of your life with us. Well, bye, all. Pardon me, folks. Merry Christmas!
Season's greetings!
Well, this is wonderful news.
Yes, wonderful news.
Annie's just found her parents. And they seem to be a very nice couple.
Yes, very nice.
You're lucky, Annie.
Right, I'm lucky. Just saying, in Jersey...
Drake, champagne.
Yes, sir.
We've got to celebrate because it's Christmas, and Annie's just found her parents. Propose a toast to Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge.
Annie.
Merry Christmas.
Have that same effect on everyone.
I've lost her, Franklin. I've lost Annie.
Sir, about that Mr. Mudge, I think I've seen him someplace before, but I just can't remember where or when. But I have the strangest feeling he is not who he says he is.
Franklin, I need your help.
Of course, Oliver. Whatever I can do for you.
Thank you. You're up early, dear.
Yes, my folks are coming for me, so I thought I'd wait for them here. You know they'll be taking me out to the country soon. Will you come visit me?
Yes. I'll see you, Annie.
You're up early, too.
Well, we've been up all night, dear. Mm-hmm. And we had quite a time of it, too. There have been FBI men coming and going. Did you know that the president was here?
Really?
I've got some very difficult news to tell you, Annie. And President Roosevelt is going to help me tell it to you.
Good morning, Annie. Lovely to see you again. Franklin. Annie, early this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. Through the newspaper and the notes on your handwriting on your notes, they succeeded in tracing the identity of your parents.
Yes, we already know, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
No, dear. They're not your parents. Your parents were David and Margaret Bennett.
David and Margaret Bennett? Where are they?
Annie, your mother and father passed away a long time ago.
You mean they're dead?
Yes, dear.
So I'm an orphan after all, like the other kids.
Are you all right, Annie?
Yes, because I guess I always knew they were dead, because they loved me, and they would have come back for me if they weren't dead.
I love you, Annie Bennett.
And I love you, too. Now, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
That a girl. Who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
I don't know, but I know that the birth certificate could have easily been forged. Only thing is, they knew about the locket.
The locket? Yes, there is your key.
But nobody knew about the locket except for us. The FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
Miss Hannigan, sir, and the children from the orphanage.
Show them in, Drake.
Yes, sir.
How do you do, Miss Hannigan? Delighted to meet you.
Stay here. I know you anywhere. You're the Oliver Warbuck, right?
Yes. Allow me to introduce you to everyone. You know, of course, my secretary, Miss Grace Farrell. And this is the President of the United States. And this is my butler, Drake.
Hi, kid.
Annie! Annie! Hi, Annie!
Gee, what a great place!
Who'd want to live in this dump?
Let's keep this present here for all of my children!
Sir, this has just arrived from the FBI.
Thank you, Drake. Comes the dawn. Now it all fits together.